It's qualifying time at Spa, one of the mightiest tracks on the Formula One calendar. Long straights, up and downhill, Eau Rouge as well. This track isn't for the faint-hearted. What kind of setup will drivers be looking for around here? It's got a fair mixture of demanding corners. Is it all about finding the sweet spot in handling balance?
It's easy to make your car quick in a straight line, you just take all the downforce off. But when it comes to a track like this, you really need a bit more of a compromise. The main focus here is carrying speed through the fast-flowing corners, but you still don't want to be a sitting duck on the straight.
We're back to the 13th episode of F1 Career Mode. This time is the 13th episode of Spa, Belize's race. We're now in Q1, in Fairline's behind. Open my DLS.冲线1分11秒是暂定排第三的，当然是入到 Q2 了，是第九位的位置，然后 Q2 了，又来到最后这个 S1 了，出弯踩油，然后冲线是排第十的，而刚刚就是这个第十位，我们就入到 Q3 了，所以我们直接 cut 到 Q3，呢度冲线1分51.23，系我哋系排第二嘅暂定。
So qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are Rosberg, Hamilton, and Sebastian Vettel. The grid is set then, so that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow, where we'll be live with all the action. And until then, it's goodbye.In the 48 races held at Spa between 1950 and 2015, the race winner has only started from pole position on 16 occasions. Qualifying yesterday may have set the order for today, but expect the unexpected here at the Belgian Grand Prix. As the saying goes, of course, anything can happen. And you know what? It usually does. So here we are once again, ready to go racing through the Ardennes Forest.4.35 miles of long straights, fast corners, and massive elevation changes. It makes this not only one of the most exciting circuits on the calendar, but one that makes for some consistently high-quality racing as well. Simply put it, there really is no place quite like Spa. Anthony Davidson is alongside me in the commentary box to take you through all the action today.Now it's a closely matched field here in Spa, and so where do you think we're going to see somebody make a difference?
If they're as close as we're expecting them to be, especially through the midfield, then being able to keep the front tyres in good condition could make the difference. You always lose a chunk of downforce at the front when you're in the turbulent air of another car, which tends to cause understeer, which in turn causes front tyre degradation. Now too much damage there could force an early pit stop and put you at a slight disadvantage.So the drivers will want to be careful not to be too aggressive early on in the Grand Prix.
Okay, remember to brake early for turn one as the pack's going to bunch up. There's plenty of runoff if things get too close.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Nico Rosberg will start his silver arrow from pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel and the Sauber, Daniel Ricciardo and Massa, Bottas, Verstappen, Hülkenberg and Carlos Sainz, Raikkonen, Perez, Kevin Magnussen and Nasser, Kvyat, Palmer, Fernando Alonso and Jenson Button, Grosjean and Gutierrez, Rio Haryanto and Pascal Wehrlein completes the grid.
好啦 ，formation lap 就排完啦。而家三盏、四盏、五盏红灯，然之后熄灯。而家正式起步。我哋而家呢个起步唔系算好好嘅，但系又唔系话好差，冇同 Vettel 最拉近。但系隔篱嘅 Ricciardo 有个非常好嘅起步，同我哋平排咗。我哋行咗外弯，继续 keep 翻个第四位，食住 Vettel 气流，食佢气流。其实以呢个速度可以 Arush 上去排佢头嘅，但系因为呢个 S1 上去排头实在有啲危险，所以我决定。等一陣喺上面呢條大直線，我先過去，繼續食住 Vettel 氣流。前面兩部 Benz 亦都鬥得好緊啦，我亦都抽個頭出嚟過 Vettel。到 S1 繼續同 Vettel 平排緊，而 然之後呢個左彎 Vettel 帶個頭出嚟嘅，但我有好啲嘅 short 彎，我繼續平排，然之後落到嚟呢個第三個彎都係繼續平排 ，Vettel 帶個少少個頭出嚟，落到發嘅彎啦，同佢鬥持 Vettel 有比位，我 lock 咗少少前胎，但我有內彎嘅優勢，所以我跑翻 Vettel。然後咁樣就排咗 Vettel 頭，而家進線第三位，但兩部 Benz 已經行到好遠啦。然後嚟到第二個圈啦，我哋上到嚟 Arush 嘅頂，即係突然間有黃旗。前面係夏美頓係 retire 咗嘅，排緊頭位嘅夏美頓，發生咩事咧？係啦，係爆計嘅，同佢2016年個 season 一樣，都係咁冇運。然後嚟到第三個圈啦，我哋入 pit 啦。後面 Vettel 又是跟住我哋入 pit 噶啦，後面仲有兩部車，一部好似係 Red Bull， 一部好似係 Williams， 係啦，係 Verstappen 嘅 Williams 同埋 Massa 定係 Bottas 我唔知啦，係邊啊？然之後換完胎出嚟，喺法拉利後面出嚟嘅，即係冇俾 Verstappen 爬頭，係啦，係 Massa 部 Williams 嘅。Verstappen 應該被人滴住咗啦，然之後出翻嚟，我哋係第17位出翻嚟嘅，嚟到第五個圈啦，我哋已經追到 Button 啦 ，Button 仲未入 pit 嘅，所以佢會阻住我哋嘅，嚟到呢堆高速 S1 啦，繼續食住 Button 喺個車尾喺佢後面。而家不停，而家真係好慢，因為佢哋胎係好舊噶啦，所以我直接喺出嚟呢、這個這個位啦，我唔識講啊，呢、這個可以踩進嘅位置，之前過去頭不停亦都見到我哋有讓開個位啦。有第六個圈啦，後面 Williams 馬莎喺我哋外面過，諗住學 Max Verstappen， 但係我呢度踩行有冇淨係放少少油，所以逼住 Massa 要壓翻後，然之後再後面呢個圈啦 ，Massa 佢今次有個非常好嘅加速，佢直接爬咗我哋頭。然後跟住 Massa 個後面嚟到呢個 bus stop chicane 追翻近，然後出彎開 DRS 追近 Massa， 嚟到第一個彎拉近咗好多啊啦距離，繼續食住 Williams 嗰啲咁嘅直線速度嚟，要做咩提高一下自己呢個直線嘅速度啊？嚟到呢個 Arush 啦。我抽咗 Massa 嘅左邊，做個 Kimi Raikkonen 嘅招牌動作，然之後 Massa 掹住上，雖然我俾曬位佢啦，佢掹到我，好明 Massa 錯噶啦，但係唔理咁多，總之爬到頭就爬到頭啦。然之後我嚟到呢個發夾彎，我 lock 咗胎，然之後 Massa 佢就會趁呢個機會爬翻我頭，但係因為下一個係左彎，但係 Massa 佢可以有個遲啲嘅 break， 所以佢帶咗少少出嚟個頭，但係。我哋繼續同佢平排，繼續夾硬同佢平排，應該咁講。嚟到呢個好高速嘅左彎啊，好高速兩個左彎啊，嚴格嚟講，我哋又爬翻 Massa 頭，繼續同 Massa 平排落到去下面一個 S 彎啊。然之後我哋係爬翻 Massa 頭嘅，但前面呢度有個呢、這個叫做咩啊，全速嘅路段 ，Williams 同 Sauber 鬥直線嘅話，你都知 Williams 一定會贏加埋。他哋有呢個 slipstream 嘅優勢，所以 Massa 就喺我後面啦，即刻爬頭啦，又嚟諗住做個 Max Verstappen 嘅招牌動作，唔叫招牌動作嘅。然之後我又俾翻 Massa 行翻去前面先啦，費事真係炒車啦。然之後嚟到 bus stop chicane， 我再抽翻，我會咩篤翻個 Massa 個內彎，爬翻 Massa 頭，出彎線咗少少，但係叫做的到嚟到呢個第九個圈啦。系啦 ，Massa 而家喺我后面啦，然之后 Massa 突然间撞我车尾，车辘甩咗，系啦，我哋嘅比利时 Grand Prix 就去到呢个位啦，变咗，睇下重播啦 ，Massa 同埋 Bottas 同埋两部 Red Bull 喺我后面，嚟到呢个全速路段啦，睇完睇唔到，转个镜头，系啦，等翻好少少先，嗱，然之后呢度。喂，呢下冇得講啦，擺明 take out 我㗎喎，你仲要自己都爆埋 Massa， 係啦，咁好唔好彩，咁我哋呢個比利時嘅 Grand Prix 就要咁樣方式完結啦。 咁好多谢你留到呢个位先啦。咁冇个好结果就真係 sorry 啦。咁係啦，期待你下一次再返嚟啦。下一站係 Monza 意大利 Grand Prix。
What do you think made the difference here?
Well, the safety car completely changed the race, didn't it? It's hard to say exactly what would have happened without it, but there's no question that they came out of that situation in a good position.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today.And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
It's got to be Romain Grosjean. He was in another league for me today, really impressive.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. Meanwhile, Renault move up the table.With another strong performance this weekend. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.